गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 12, लेट्स स्टार्ट. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दी सब्स्टिट्यूशन रिएक्शन, दैट इज SN1 एंड SN2, देयर रिस्पेक्टिव मैकेनिज्म. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट SN2 मैकेनिज्म, दैट इज सब्स्टिट्यूशन न्यूक्लियोफिलिक बायमोलिक्यूलर. दिस टाइप ऑफ मैकेनिज्म इज जनरली फॉलोड बाई दी प्राइमरी हैलाइड्स एंड इट इज अ वन स्टेप मैकेनिज्म. द ब्रेकिंग ऑफ द कार्बन हैलोजन बॉन्ड एंड मेकिंग ऑफ द कार्बन न्यूक्लियोफाइल बॉन्ड अकर्स साइमल्टेनियसली. The nucleophile approaches the carbon atom from the side opposite to that carrying the halogen atom. This is because the attack from the side of the halogen atom is hindered due to the repulsion between the negatively charged halogen and the nucleophile. Okay, so if I take the example of reaction between methyl bromide and KOH aqueous, methyl bromide, which I am writing like this, this is my CH3Br, okay, this is my plane, okay, and this one is the bond above the plane and this is the bond below the plane, okay. Now OH negative, reaction of methyl bromide in presence of aqueous KOH means what? Aqueous KOH provides us OH negative. This OH negative is the incoming nucleophile or the incoming group. It will be attacking from the opposite side. This is the backside attack, okay, because same side attack is hindered due to this bond. Right? Now what happens? This is the transition state. Del negative. This is OH del negative. Now this one is the transition state. Okay, which is actually hypothetical. Now after this, what do we get? We get this one. This bond shifts over here and the above bond this is the thing that happens, okay. Like in this case the above bond was placed over here. Now as it is attacking from the opposite side, the above bond goes to this side and the bond below comes to this side, right. Now there is basically inversion of configuration, okay. This configuration represents inversion of configuration, right. And here, as we have already said, that the bond formation and the bond breaking occurs at the same stage. Now this reaction is bimolecular reaction. Why? It is SN2, that means it is bimolecular. Now why is it bimolecular? Because in the slow step, this is the slow step, in the slow step both nucleophile and alkyl halide is involved. So rate equals to, or rate is proportional to this one, alkyl halide concentration and incoming nucleophile or NU negative. Since two molecules, one is nucleophile, other one is alkyl halide, so it is a bimolecular reaction and it is a single step reaction. Okay, now the rates of SN2 reaction, it follows the order. I mean the rates of SN2 reactions of the alkyl halides follows this order. There is primary, greater than secondary, greater than tertiary alkyl group. It can be explained on the basis of the effect of the size of the groups attached to the carbon carrying the halogen atom. In case of tertiary halides, the three alkyl groups attached to the carbon carrying the halogen makes a backside attack on the carbon difficult. Now this is basically termed as a steric hindrance. Okay, thus the rate of the reaction decreases. The hindrance to the backside attack is less in case of secondary halides and almost negligible in case of primary halides, due to which the order of the reactivity in case of SN2 reaction is greater for primary R group. Primary means primary R group means primary alkyl group, then secondary R group greater than tertiary R group. This is basically due to the reason of steric effect. Okay, greater the size of the alkyl group, higher the bulkiness, the backside attack is disfavored. That's why. Now we move to SN2 mechanism. SN2, as the name indicates, substitution nucleophilic, we move to SN1. This was SN2. We move to SN1, that is substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. okay, this is this one. Now, this is a two-step reaction or a two-step mechanism. In the first step, what happens? Carbon-halogen bond breaking occurs and formation of carbocation occurs. Second step, the incoming nucleophile will be attacking the carbocation. Now, this particular mechanism or SN1 rate, it depends on the stability of the carbocation formed. On the other hand, in case of SN2, the rate of the reaction, it basically depends on the size of the alkyl group. It depends on the steric factor. But in case of SN1, it depends on the stability of the carbocation. So let's start. If I take this one, tertiary alkyl halide. First step, that is a slow step, which is the RDS. This bond will be broken. This is a heterolytic fission. So Br negative formed. And this is the carbocation form. This is a 3-degree carbocation and this is stabilized by what? By plus I effect and by hyperconjugation effect. In the second step, my incoming nucleophile will be attacking. If I take the incoming nucleophile as OH negative, it will be attacking this cation. And we are going to get tertiary butyl alcohol. Okay. So here the rate of the reaction, it depends on the stability of the carbocation. Rate is equals to or proportional to the alkyl halide. Since one molecule is involved, so it is unimolecular reaction. One molecule involved where? In the slow step. This one is the slow step or the RDS, rate determining step. This one is the fast step. Okay. And in case of SN2, we had only one step. Right, so here it depends only on the alkyl halide concentration. That is, it depends on the stability of the carbocation. Okay, which is what? 3 degree greater than 2 degree greater than 1 degree. And if we have benzylic or allylic carbocations, they have additional stability due to the resonance. Okay. Now, if I talk about the nature of the solvent, then SN1 reaction, they are favored by polar protic solvent. Polar protic solvent means those solvent which can form hydrogen bonds, right? They can solvate the cations, because here we are having carbocations formed. So here this solvation is very essential. So if a polar protic solvent is present, the rate of SN1 reaction is increasing. Polar protic solvent means water, alcohol, etc. And rate of SN2 reaction increases in presence of polar aprotic solvent like DMSO, that is dimethyl sulfoxide, DMF, dimethyl formamide. That's it. Okay, so that's it, class 12. Thank you.